Hey guys, welcome to the ultimate mutation guide for ArkMobile. So I gathered all the information to make the most requested video on my channel for ArkMobile. Before I get more into the video, I need to say, I don't have a mic, so I'm using this TTS software to bring some form of audio to explain what's going on in the video. Hope you understand and learn more about mutations in ArkMobile. I'm gonna make this video into multiple parts, so I can explain everything I know, and I gathered throughout the years I've played Ark. This is the part 1 of our mutation guide. In this one we are mainly focusing on the basics, which are taming, stat selection, and stat combining, so we can make our perfect breeding pair. Step 1. Taming. Taming is the most important thing on our guide, cuz without a tamed creature, you can't breed and make mutated babies. For this video I'm using raptors. But you can tame any creature you want that can be breeded in the game. Tame max or close to max level dinos you can find, cuz they're going to have the best stats. I'm gonna leave a chart for the best levels to tame on different difficulties. I am playing on medium difficulty, so I'm going for anything between 140 and 150. And, tame with 100% effectiveness, so you can get the taming bonus. Because you'll get bonus levels for taming, and these levels will be randomly added to the creature's stats after taming. So higher the effectiveness, better the stats. A side note, for the hardcore stat breeders out there, before you tame any creature, always check their base stats. That's going to be a great boost for mutation stacking. The best way to check the base stat is to use DodoDex. Just take the stat for the wild creature and put the values in DodoDex. Here we can see that our raptor have low stam for a level 150, also the other stats are average for this level. I don't recommend this raptor to tame, but I'm taming this one so I can save some time. Now tame as many creature you can. For ArkMobile the best amount of dinos to tame for breeding is 6, so I'll bring you back after that. I tamed 6 max level raptors, and named them with a number and the generation it's from. I recommend naming your breeders so you don't lose track. Step 2. Stat selection. Stat selection is a process of selecting the good stats from the dinos you tamed for breeding. I have created a chart to explain stat selection, so let's take a look at that. Here we can see that I only chose the health, stam, weight and melee stats of our raptors. Cuz they're the more useful stats on any creature. Now we need to pick the best stats out of all of our raptors. Let's start with health. Here we can see that raptor 6 have the highest health out of all of our raptors, and raptor 2 have the highest stam, raptor 1 have highest weight, and raptor 3 has the highest melee. So this is what stat selection is: taming as many creatures you want to mutate and selecting the best stats out of them so you can make the breeding pair, so you can start the breeding. Step 3. Stats combining. Stats combining is the process of getting all the good stats that we just selected onto a pair of creatures. So, we need to take all of our good stats raptors and breed them until we get a male and female with all the good stats of our Gen 0 raptors. Here we can see that we have 1 male and 3 female raptors with our good stats. From these, I'm gonna take the male R2 with the high stam and R1, our weight female. Now breed these two until we get a male with the stam and weight from these two. I've been breeding R2 male and R1 female to get a male with both of their stats. And here we have it, our Gen 1, male with the stam and weight from R1 and R2. Now I'm gonna take the Gen 1 male we just got, and breed it with R3, our Gen 0 female, which have the best melee. Until we get another male with the stam and weight from the Gen 1 male, and the melee from R3, our Gen 0 female. So, I hope most of you caught what I'm doing. If you still have any doubt, maybe this could help. So, let me show you a brief note on what I was doing. I was trying to combine all the good stats from our Gen 0 raptors onto a male and female raptor, so we can have a perfect breeding pair. For that, we started by breeding R2 the male raptor, with the high stam, with R1, our high weight female. From these two, we got R1, our Gen 1 male with both of their good stats. And I took that male and breed it with R3, the Gen 0 female with high melee. Until I got a male with both of their stats. And got R2, R Gen 1 male with good stam, weight and melee from the others. And I breed that male with R final Gen 0 female which had the highest health, until I got a male and female with the same health, stam, weight and melee. If you followed this video, then you would be left with a male and female, non-mutated creatures with all the good stats from the wild dinos you tamed. And these two raptors are what I'm left with, which have all the good stats from the wild raptors I tamed. Also keep in mind that, if you breed any tamed creature in the game, there is a chance for a mutations to occur at any point on the breeding, and that may result on a baby with a mutation. Mainly what I do if I get a mutation during stats combining. I just check if that mutation is on a stat that I'm currently breeding to combine, if not I check if the mutation landed on a stat that I want to combine. Here's what to do if a mutation occurred during stats combining. Imagine, you're breeding a raptor with 5 melee with a raptor that has 50 health to get a baby with both of these stats. And a mutation occurred during this process. First thing you gotta do is to check, if the mutation landed on any of the stats that you're currently breeding to combine. If the mutation did landed on a stat you're trying to combine. For example, the mutation landed on R melee stat. And give plus 2 points to R melee increase from 5 to 7. I don't keep creatures that get mutated during stats combining. Because I'll always love to start with fully combined non-mutated ones. Then I can have a fresh canvas to paint. So, I recommend don't keep the mutations you get during stats combining. Guys, I hope you all learned something from our part 1 of the mutations guide. And if you did, a like would be a great boost to this video. Also subscribe and help me grow this channel. So I'll see you with the part 2 until then, it's me, RJ, and I'll see you on the island.